But what do you think men look for in women? If they're going to take you seriously, if they're going to give you full commitment, and especially if they're going to put a ring on that finger, if they're going to wipe you up and commit to you long term. And that's the question I want to start off with. And yeah, I'll start with you. Go ahead, Leena. Take it away.
Okay. Let's see. So I would say the thing that men probably look for in a relationship when they're going long term is if they, assuming they have a healthy relationship with their mom, I feel they look for the qualities that their mom has. So whatever they grew up with, that type of nurturing environment, that's what they seek. You know, they want to know that there's a place where they can be vulnerable and be comfortable. So kind of like that motherly love, nurturing, caring, kind, soft, gentle. I feel like that's something that a lot of men look for, because when they're in public, you know, society kind of tells men that they be tough. And so they want a place where they don't have to have that persona, where they can just let loose. And so I think that's, yeah, that like soft and gentle personality is what a lot of men look for. And I think that's it. That soft personality also leads to a woman that's forgiving and kind, which leads to a long lasting relationship, because when he does make mistakes, you have someone that's understanding and can forgive and then can build from that. So that's okay. Yeah, the short version of my answer. And I think someone that doesn't have a healthy relationship with their mom, that's when toxicity comes in.
Okay, all right. So I got nurturing, that feminine figure, which is his mom. That's always the man's first feminine figure in his life, his mom. Kind, forgiving. Anything you want to add on to it? Add on to that? Things that you might think that men are looking for, or men are not attracted, or men are repulsed by if women do these certain behaviors that may retract them from taking them seriously.
And then, I mean, I kind of talked about it from like the non-physical side, but on the physical side, I think men really appreciate women that, you know, take care of themselves. Obviously, yeah. Just something that maintains that physical attractiveness. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just generally like that. A woman, she doesn't necessarily have to fit in a certain box, because I've seen a lot of guys marry actually the girl that's not their type, but they just have to be confident in their attributes, whatever they have. If they're confident in it and they know how to work it, then mm-hmm. you don't have to have a specific type to be.
All right. Okay. So women that take care of themselves, you know. Okay, no worries. So yeah, I got all that down. Anything else?
No, that's it for me.
All right. Cool. All right. That's a good list. All right. So same question. Anikka, what do you think men are looking for in women to take them seriously, to fully commit to them and also wipe them up one day?
So first of all, Leena, yours was super deep. And so me going second, it's like following up. But I would say like compromise, and that wouldn't have been in years before. That wouldn't have been my first answer at all. Mm-hmm. But watching or like being in a relationship and just being like in friendships in general, there's a lot of like, hey, I'm super clean, but if you don't do this, then I can't freak out about it because to you, it's not a big deal. Or like, hey, I don't necessarily, you know, love the whole like going out to a bar, but I trust you. And that's a compromise because of like the trust we've built. So, you know, go ahead and do that because you trust me to do the same. And I think that's been built on not only trust, but that compromise to like understand that we value different things, but our mm-hmm. overall values are the same. So the compromise kind of like evens out, because there's never one person in the relationship that goes over mm-hmm. because we respect each other's like overall values. Mm-hmm. So I'd say like compromise for sure, being able to be flexible.
All right, anything else? All right, so compromise, anything else? What do we know? You think that's it?
Yeah.
What are the, okay. Anything else you want to add to it? Like, you know, anything else besides what Leena already shared, like anything else that you see in men today, like if they know if a woman's behaving this certain way, they're like, nah, I'm not wife of that.
I don't know. It's kind of difficult because you hear different things on the media of like girls being confident and girls being like,
ooh,
these really confident girls. And there's either guys that can handle it, that love it, that are attracted to it because they're like, cool, I'm not going to have to be worried about if she wants to spend time with me because she's not going to want to because we're both going to be starting our own businesses. You know what I mean? But then there's other people, like other guys who are still stuck in what, like what Leena was saying, like that they feel like they have to be masculine outside of the house. So they're still stuck in that like masculine energy. And when they feel like someone else is when they feel like someone else is threatening that, then they might be deterred. So I would say it's like hit or miss with the confidence of females.
So you're saying go ahead, Lena.
Yeah, on that. Yes. That is so true. Okay. So I said confidence, but there are some guys that take confidence. You know, when a woman walks into a room and every guy is like, you know, eyes are automatically on her, right? Because she walks into the room and she owns it. And there's some guys that are out there and they're like, yeah, like that's my girl. You know, she can have anyone in this room, but she chose me. And that's their confidence. There's other guys that are like, she can have everyone in this room and she chose me. Like, and that's their insecurity. So so I think that's like a really big thing is that, it, like she said, it depends on the type of guy. If he can handle that confidence is really, really important.
Okay. All right. So confidence, confidence in women. All right. So that's what guys are looking for, the wife of a confident woman. And you said something about, I just want to make sure I have it clear. So Anikka, you said something about masculine energy. Can you elaborate on that? What do you mean by that?
Yeah. So there's actually different types. If like either of you are into like spirituality, there's different types of energy. So like masculine and feminine energy.
Mm-hmm, of course.
Masculine energy being like that logical, get it done side. And that's like the productive side, which is good. But there needs to be balance in humans. So like there needs to be that logical, get work done, productive side, but there also needs to be that creative side. But unfortunately, most men don't elaborate and they don't express that feminine side because it's wrong. So that's what I meant.
Okay, no worries. All right, so anything else you want to add to that, Anikka?
No, that's it.
Okay, all right. So, okay, ladies. All right, so I love everything you guys said, but are you guys ready to hear the truth of what men really look for?
Like, let me know.
All right. Because that's, you know, it's just interesting for me. You know, that's why I love this podcast. It's just, you know, and that's one of the things I've just noticed in today's dating culture today is a misunderstanding between men and women that a lot of men don't know what women want. And also a lot of women out there I've seen, it's just daters understand what men are looking for. But I would say this. I would say that, Leena, everything you said about the feminine figure, that's one of the things I always tell ladies all the time that, men are always looking for a feminine woman, nurturing, caring, loving, right? And especially a guy that's very masculine or a guy that's very confident in himself. It's just we're always looking for the traits that complement us, right? So if I'm a very strong, confident, ambitious man, I'm looking for traits that complement mine. I'm not looking for the same traits I already have because I already bring that to the table, if that makes sense to you guys. And this is something I always have to explain to ladies. If I'm a confident, strong, ambitious man, I'm not looking to bring the same thing. I'm not looking at that from a partner. I'm looking for something to compliment me. Like I think Leena said, I'm looking for that vulnerability. I'm looking for that softness because I'm already strong as a man. So it just complements it. If I'm already headstrong, I'm not looking for somebody that's headstrong, ambitious. And so feminine is one of the top things that men look for. A lot of men like a feminine woman, nurturing, caring, the mother figure in his life, the kindness. I would say the taking care of themselves. Of course, yeah, I know guys like a woman who has a nice body and takes care of themselves. You know, as long as you take care of themselves, because, you know, one of the things that men do care about is because we are more visual. Like we care about a woman's beauty. You know, we like a beautiful woman. So depending on the guy, whatever, as long as he's attracted to you, but taking care of yourself does help. Does help in your chance of attracting a guy. So sometimes I tell ladies all the time, and I'm just keeping it real with them. I do see a lot of ladies not taking care of themselves, you know, just getting overweight or just getting obese, you know, and all of a sudden, yeah, that can be a reason. That can be a reason why guys are not attracted to you, because guys, we do care about how our woman looks, and we want to be with a beautiful woman. Depending on what they're looking for, every guy wants to be attracted to their woman. And then the one thing I did find, I love what you guys said, confidence, right? So I think one of the biggest mistakes a lot of women, they don't know the difference between confident and being masculine, if that makes sense. Because I like a confident woman. I like a woman that speaks her mind. I like a woman who has her own opinion. I love a very intellectual woman that can challenge me mentally, intellectually. But there's a difference between confident and acting like a man, if you guys know what I'm talking about. Because I know a lot of women are confident, but they're still feminine, if that makes sense. Right? They're still feminine. They're still, they still have the nurturing, caring, and gentle side. But I know today, because a lot of women today are very career-oriented, they have to pursue their goals and dreams. But, you know, in order to pursue your goals and dreams and compete with men in the workplace, you have to become a man yourself. You have to be very masculine yourself to compete in the workplace, depending on your industry, right? So I do notice that a lot of women today, they are very masculine. They do act like a man or betray that man or have that man attitude. And for a lot of guys, they're not attracted, especially if it's a masculine guy. He's not attracted to a woman that has that acts like a guy. Like, I don't want to be talking to another guy in a relationship. I feel like I'm talking to another dude. I want to talk to another woman. All right. I want to feel your femininity. I want to feel your softness, your gentleness, your kindness. So a lot of women don't know the difference, because I don't know if you heard that term, you know, I'm sure you've heard it. Strong, independent women. Right. So there's a lot of strong, independent women. It's like, I don't need a man. I don't need no man. I can do everything by myself. And I always tell ladies, well, if you have that attitude that you don't need a man, then a man's like, if you don't need me, okay. Or if you don't need me in your life, I'm going to go to the feminine woman and say, hey, I'm looking for a man. So if you have that attitude, like I said, I love confident women. But if you have the attitude, like, I don't need you. And have you heard that term? I don't need a man. It's all over social media. Usually the girls, are, you know, there's a lot, you know, they're just broken up or it's too hurt from the previous relationship. but yeah, I've heard that all. I've had friends like that, and I've heard that from a lot of women. Like, I don't need a man. I'm independent. I don't need, I can do anything on my own. And for a man, that's like, it's not unattractive, because like, you're talking like a man. So they're always looking for a feminine woman. The one thing I always tell ladies out there, we shouldn't be pushing for independence. We should be pushing for interdependence. Interdependence is relying on one another, right? Because that's what relationships are. You know, as a man, like, we want to rely on a woman. As a woman, you guys want to rely on me. You know, you shouldn't go into a relationship, hey, I don't need you. You know, because pretty much that's what you're saying. If I'm independent, I don't need you. Like, ladies, how would you guys feel if a man came up to you and was like, hey, let's be in a relationship. I don't need you, though. I don't need you.
Well, I feel like maybe the way they say it might be not the best, but I disagree with what you said, because...
Go ahead.
I think that being able to do things on your own is important, and having that interdependence is good, but sometimes people take it way too far and it becomes toxic, because that interdependence is like, well, I need you here so you can't go out type of thing, or I need you here, and you know, there just becomes like so much toxicity that interdependence is now like that. It's just bad. Like, that person isn't their own person anymore. They're literally, not literally, but they might as well be like attached to that person, since there's like, they can't do anything on their own. They don't feel like they can.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead,
Leena.
Yeah, I definitely agree with her in that. I kind of disagree with that, because I think there's something much better that comes from a relationship where, I mean, not necessarily, you guys are not necessarily telling each other, I don't need you, but it's kind of like a known fact. Like, I was okay before you. I'm better with you, obviously, but I'd be okay without you. Like, knowing that, yeah, we don't need each other, but we want each other, like, it builds a different type of relationship. That means that, like, this is not something we have to do. It's something we want to do. We're working towards this because we have that same goal. And when a woman is independent, she starts to, her the type of man that she wants kind of narrows down to people, like you said, the complimentary type of guy. Instead, when she, you have someone that's really feminine and doesn't really have a life outside of a relationship, she starts to settle, I think, for just someone that would give her, you have so many girls just begging for the bare minimum sometimes. So I think when she does have her own life, she can have masculine energy when she's in a job, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't have to follow her in the home. I mean, I'm speaking as an engineer, because when I go, I think I'm one of like three females in my office. So I do have to, you know, assert some type of masculine energy when I'm around these
guys. You have to.
Yeah, but when I'm with my partner, I would never talk to him the way that I talk to them. I talk to him, yeah, much softer. It's a different type of person. Obviously, you talk to a kid much different than you talk to your parent. So I think it's totally fine for a woman to be masculine in the career, outside her home or whatever it is. And even sometimes to her man, if he's acting a certain way and she has to like level out the field, it's perfectly fine. But yeah, so I just had a comment that... Because I say I don't need a man a lot.
No, I totally understand. Like, and you broke it down perfectly, Leena. You know, like I said, I don't, for women, I want you guys, I have no problem with women going out there and be successful. You know, that's the whole purpose of why you guys were able to get the opportunities, you know, when we changed all those laws, you guys have the same opportunities have that we have now. But I always tell ladies on my podcast, like, you have to switch that role of that hat. You know, when you're at the workplace, be masculine, be dominant, kill it, go be the best woman you can be, start your business, be successful in a career. But the one thing they don't understand is that doesn't work when it comes to a relationship with a man. You have to learn to switch that role and go back into your femininity as a woman, because at the end of the day, that's what men are always looking for. They're looking for that femininity. And Leena said it best, you know, they the first person that they got the love from was from their mom. So their mom, so they always looking for, like, I think women do the same thing. You know, the first man in your life was your father. So you always look guys that have similar traits, and the type of love that your father showed you, that's the love that you always seek from the men in your life. And the same thing from men as well. If they had a healthy relationship with your mom, they're always looking for that kindness and that softness. So you can be dominant in the workplace, but a lot of times I see a lot of modern women today, they don't know how to turn that switch. So they come home with the dominant attitude and that energy to their husband, and that's caused a lot of conflicts, right? And I mentioned you guys before, like, especially if you're talking about very masculine men, a guy that's already confident in himself, dominant, ambitious, he's already in tune with his masculinity. So if you come home and be masculine yourself or act like a man yourself, when he's looking for that gentle, for that woman, that nurturing care and the kindness from that from a woman, but you're acting like a man, that can cause a lot of issues in relationships. And there are studies that show, I don't know if you guys look into those type of studies, there are studies that show that the women today in America that are the highest rate of women today in America that are single, the demographic is women that are career-oriented women that make a lot of money. So the more money a woman makes between 30 and 45, the women who are very career-oriented over the age of 30, 45, they make a lot, earn a higher income, they struggle. Those are the type of women right now in America. They don't get they either don't get married, or they end up getting married and getting divorced later, and they're single, because like I said, they're very masculine. You know, because they have to be in their workplace. They just haven't learned how to tap into their femininity and be feminine for their man.